Steve McLaren began season 2002-2003 well aware that the second year in the hot seat is often far tougher than the first. But Mac was ready for the challenge. After coming through his baptism in management by establishing the club in a respectable 12th place, he was ready to serve up for the Riverside faithful some wonderful attacking football and to try to move Boro up to the next level. On home territory, Mac was ready to attack and bring the entertainment back. The story of Steve McLaren's second term begins with a hectic close season as the manager worked tirelessly to bring new faces to the club. Frank Queuedrue eagerly accepted the chance to make his loan spell into a permanent transfer as Boro paid loans £2.5 million for his services, but with the defence finalised, focus turned to the midfield and to the attack. Massimo Maccarone arrived as one of the rising young talents in Europe. The price paid to Empoli of £8.15 million was a club record, for the 22-year-old had already won his first cap for Italy and had been the jewel in the crown of their under-21 side that had defeated England in the European Championships. A gamble possibly, but the young striker was clearly a player with huge potential. In the midfield, George Boateng was signed as the natural successor to Paul Ince, and the Dutch international would prove to be a wise acquisition. McLaren then moved quickly as Geremi's permanent transfer to Chelsea from Real Madrid stalled, and the boss brought the Cameroon international on a short-term contract. Geremi had been capped more than 50 times for his country and scored a terrific free kick against England before the World Cup. Geremi was ready to make the Premiership sit up and take notice. The final piece in the manager's summer spending spree was perhaps the most dramatic of all, as the fans' number one player of all time, Juninho, returned for his third spell at the Riverside. This time, he was a World Cup winner, and Teesside was ready to go samba crazy all over again.
Geremi delivers the cross and it comes through and the ball is in the net, and would you believe it?
Everything now seemed set for success, but sadly in the final build-up game in Italy, tragedy was to strike as Juninho suffered the agony of a cruciate ligament injury that would condemn him to an operation and months of painful rehabilitation work. The samba star was back, but he wouldn't shine at the Riverside for some time, and the pain went to the heart of Boro supporters everywhere. Nevertheless, the season was all